Well, hello, hello, my brothers and sisters in Christ. And this is Brother West. This is Prophet West coming to you again briefly. And I do have a direct word that I want to speak into your ears. And one of the things that I'm noticing, and one of the things that I see, and one of the reasons that I notice, and the one thing that I see is because the things that I'm noticing, I'm seeing, is happening to me. And the fact that we're connected. The Bible says that we're connected. We're joined. We're yoked together. We're the same body, different administrations, but it's the same spirit. And so, seeing that we're connected, then one thing that I know for a fact is that in your life, is God is starting to turn things around. He is turning things around, and I know this for myself because it's. It's like the trauma that I've been through over the last 5 years, from losing my mother, from losing my sister, losing my niece, and my son being paralyzed. And actually, I didn't even let you know about one of the things that my oldest son passing as well, and at 40 years old. And so all those things that happened at one time, it seems like it kept on coming, pain kept on coming, hurt kept on coming, all that. And so for so long, I will say this, for so long, my heart has been heavy. For so long, I've been fighting depression. I've been fighting all kind of things, but pressing my way and seeking the face of God and asking God to deliver me, asking God to release and relieve my heart. And I can truly and completely and totally say that God has delivered me and God has healed my heart. And because God has healed my heart, I can see it for a fact that, and I can see it, how God is restoring things back in my life, restoring things that I lost or things that I let go of, or things that I didn't pay attention to, or things that I didn't acknowledge, or things that I didn't know that God was blessing me with. All those things God's returning back. And so this is what I see with you, beloved of God. I see God returning blessings, returning jobs, returning love, returning relationships. I see it. And the thing about it, where many of you at, and what you have to be careful of in this place where God is beginning to restore, God is beginning to cause you to receive those things back. You have to, the Bible says, submit unto the Lord, submit unto God. Then after you submit unto God, resist the devil and he will flee. And so what's going to happen is that the adversary, the enemy, he's going to try to find, and see, the wicked one now, he's searching, he's roaming, and he's trying to find your vulnerability, but he's trying to find your weak spot. He's trying to get you to react. He's trying to poke at you. He's trying to jug you. He's trying to get you to get out of character. And so why he's trying to do that is because he's trying to distract you. He's trying to get you off focus. See, because God is speaking to you and you're closer than never before to what God has for you. And because you're close than never before to what God has for you, the enemy sees that. And because he sees that, he's coming on strong. He's using anyone he can. See, but the Bible says to submit yourself unto God. Then after you submit yourself unto God, resist the devil. Keep resisting him. And see, the thing about it, the thing that you feed will grow. And so many things that in your life that keep reoccurring, situations keep reoccurring, people keep reoccurring, circumstances keep recurring. And in your mind, you're saying, God, I'm tired of it. I want the end. I want to stop. And so if you want things to change, you change. And so one way to change certain things and certain cycles is to break it. And the way to break it is to ignore it, to resist it, and to stop feeding it. See, because I use this example a lot. If a cat come to my door, if I put down milk, that cat going to keep coming. But if I stop, if I pull that milk back, and I take my milk back, that cat gonna go somewhere else. And so some of you, God is saying, stop feeding it. If you stop feeding it, it'll go somewhere else. Stop feeding it. Stop feeding those conversations. Stop feeding that fear. Stop feeding those conversations in your mind. Stop feeding the urge to want to gossip. Stop feeding the urge to want to talk about people. Stop feeding the urge to want to get back at people. Stop the urge. And see, what God is breaking cycles. God is changing many of your habits. There are some of you, and you just discovered that all of a sudden, certain patterns and things that you once did, God is taking your attention away from doing the things that you normally used to do. And because he's taking your mind and he's taking you away from the things that you normally used to do and putting more on him, you notice that you're finding liberty. You'll notice that your mind is more clear. And see, oftentimes when you watch TV and all that mess sometimes, it junks your mind up. And so a lot of times in your head, you got junk mail. And so what you got to do with junk mail, you got to get rid of it. Got to get rid of the junk mail. And so this is what God is doing. God wants you to release yourself and God wants you to set yourself free. Amen. God bless you. Have a good day. God bless you and heaven smile on you. But just be encouraged. Be encouraged. Be encouraged. Be encouraged because the change, things are turning. Things are flipping. God is flipping things. Matter of fact, there was a word that God gave me one time. And the word was that a year ago, you were under the table. Circumstances, you were under the table. You were under the table and so many things. Under stress. Under bills. Under pain, under duress. You was under all of that. But God said, now the table's turned. And so the thing that was on top of you and that you was under, now you're on top of that. You're on top of it. The table has turned. It's turned. God bless you.